Long time no see. So I'm in Singapore right now. I've been here for about 3 nights, and we were supposed to leave today, but long story short, we decided to extend our stay for another 2 nights, so my friend can finish his paper, so I can finally finish this video and send it out. So my trip to Thailand was quite amazing. It was much too quick, but I did as much as I could in the short amount of time that I had. So my trip was 2 nights in Bangkok, and then I traveled up to northern Thailand to Chiang Mai, where coincidentally a good friend's mom was there and I was able to see her, which was quite a fun and neat experience. And then on the last night I was actually traveling back to Bangkok on an overnight train. Alright, with no further ado, let's go explore Thailand. I got 15 minutes to flight boards, 14-hour flight to a 5-hour layover in Singapore, and then an hour and a half from Singapore to Bangkok.
Here we go.
Now I'm in Bangkok, and I forgot my deodorant. I need to get a handle on this. I need to go get on the train and get to my hostel. Yeah, here we go. Thailand, Bangkok. I just got off the bus, following people because I don't know where the train is. And it's worked before. So hopefully these people know where they're going. Oh, I think I see it. Wrong way. We have arrived. I'm in my hostel in Bangkok. What a journey. I'm sitting on top of my bed and the creepy cat that was outside of the window just left. I was gonna show you. It was a little bit of a fiasco. Left the airport. Got into A1, which is the bus that was supposed to take me to the subway. It didn't. And then I was walking around asking people for help. Lots of people were helpful. Most people just didn't speak much English. I asked a lady on the bus. She was hanging outside the bus, and I walked up to her and I showed her Google Maps. And she looks at me. She speaks something in Thai and then just starts like raising her eyebrows and smirking. It was, I think, solely your and I appreciated that. So then I forked over the 250 baht, which is 10-ish dollars, and took a taxi to my hostel. I know, I took the easy way out, but I think that was a 32-hour travel day, so. Good morning. Day 2 in Bangkok. Unfortunate event occurred last night on the roof.
Here's the roof!
While my camera was mounted to my tripod. My back was turned and I heard a loud thump. Found my camera lens completely obliterated. So today I'm gonna go to a camera store that was recommended to me by some of the people at the hostel and see if I could find a replacement, because it'd be really unfortunate to go to Chiang Mai, which is northern Thailand, tomorrow and not have a good camera. So that's what I'm doing today. I'm gonna also try and go to some temples. So that is the itinerary for today. I will talk to you guys later. We're going on the boat, little boat, for like 10 baht. We're gonna go down the canal and see some temples. Nice gentleman just helped me. There's a boat for 200 baht, and then this little boat's only 9 baht. So, bargain.
think I'm a
Golden Mountain Temple in Bangkok. And the weather is matching the intensity of it. Really special. I think I get to Chiang Mai around 2 o'clock. Tomorrow morning, I get picked up by someone from the Elephant Sanctuary. It's gonna be a quick trip to Chiang Mai because I'm staying there tonight and then Elephant Sanctuary tomorrow morning, afternoon, and then in the evening, I think around 6 or 7, I leave on the overnight train back to Bangkok and then I fly to Singapore. So here we go. I just got to Chiang Mai. It's really nice to be away from the city. Bangkok was really neat, but a little overwhelming at times. I think I'm gonna go find food. A really neat thing that I wanted to share that happened on the first night in Bangkok was I was standing outside of my hostel and this very old woman with a cane walks out with a bag of trash and is like 15 feet, if not more, away from this small trash can. Just lobs her trash up and it like hits the side and then falls in. She looks at me, smiles, and like raises an eyebrow and like shrugs. That was amazing. Hello. We're about to go see the elephants. It was pouring on our way here. It's cleared up right now, but we'll see if it lasts. Let's go see some elephants.
You know, girl, that every little thing you do, even when I'm feeling blue, oh, it makes me smile. Yes, we're going through some stormy weather. Bless the fact we still move together. I know we'll find the light on the other side. Cause we'll be just fine. We'll be just fine if we take our time. Take our time. Let the sun shine. Cause we'll be just fine. Oh, 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 oh. Cause we'll be just fine.
My name is Chai.
Chai, nice to meet you.
Right now we are in the Mewa area. This is like Elephant Jungle Sanctuary, camp number 8. Our Elephant Jungle Sanctuary started 4 years ago with 3 elephants, 1 camp. Right now we have 9 locations with 2 to 3 elephants. All the elephants we took them from riding camp and logging camp. After they came here, no riding, no working anymore. Just to only feed them, bought them. You can see right now elephants, they have very good life,
yeah.
Because of nobody riding them.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
They're also like happy. You see they're happy, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, really happy. Hopefully in the future, if everybody support elephant like this,
yeah, yeah.
No more riding camp.
Yeah.
Cause we'll be just fine. Just if we take our time.
Come on, buddy.
Let the sun shine. Cause we'll be just fine. Just let the sun shine. Let the sun shine. Let the sun shine. Let the sun shine.
Train sleeping.